We are honored to welcome Jose Linares, Chief Judge of the New Jersey Federal District Court. Good to see you, Judge.
Good to see you, Steve.
Describe what the New Jersey Federal District Court is.
Well, the Federal District Court is the federal branch of the judiciary in New Jersey. Of course, most people are familiar with the state court system, from the municipal court level to the tenancy courts to the family court to the state courts. The federal judiciary, it's different. It's New Jersey is the oldest united district court in the country, meaning that it's only one district. And we service cases that deal with federal litigation, patent litigation, immigration cases, Social Security appeals. So it's a court of special jurisdiction in that in order to get into our court, you have to have a special type of jurisdiction, whether it's a federal question that's at issue, a constitutional issue, something like that. And the judges in the federal system are appointed by the president and with the advice and consent of the Senate. So in that sense, it's also different.
Judge, you told me recently off camera that we have a crisis. What's a crisis?
We do. We have a judicial crisis in New Jersey. I say that because our court is an extremely busy court. We are a 17-judge court, active judge court. The federal judiciary, who tracks numbers and filings and so forth, has determined we really should be at a 20-judge court. And we're trying to get Congress to increase the number of judges in New Jersey to 20. But as of right now, we have, in essence, 5 vacancies out of 17, and we're going to be up to 6 come next year, or at least potentially 6 if one of the judges that becomes senior eligible next year chooses to go senior status.
So, how does that impact our lives in New Jersey?
It impacts your lives a lot. When you think about it, New Jersey, and just to put it in perspective, from 2016 to 2017, we had a 47% increase in case filings. We're top among the Third Circuit, second, we're top in the Third Circuit, fourth in the nation, the number of filings, seventh in weighted cases, which means complex, complicated cases. And we handle a ton of pharmaceutical patent work and criminal cases. So how does that affect the citizens of New Jersey? Okay, we have an opioid crisis in New Jersey right now. Tons of problems arising out of that with criminal cases, reentry programs, and these are cases that come to the court.
What happens if there's no judge to handle them?
It becomes a huge problem. Now, under federal statute, there is a Speedy Trial Act, which means that the criminal case has got to go first, okay, which has a trickle-down effect on the other cases. You got to understand, too, and I mentioned the pharmaceutical because we're very heavily involved in patent litigation in New Jersey. 14 out of the 20th largest pharmaceutical places are in New Jersey. And as a result, we have a lot of that litigation.
So holding up patents.
Some of that patent litigation between generics and branded drug manufacturers have to come to conclusion within 30 months. So now you have the opioid problems, the gangs, the criminal cases. That goes first. Then you have this other 30-month cases that have to be tried. Delaware and New Jersey combined for 90% of that type of litigation. 90% in the entire country. We're second in the country with the most vacancies right now.
Why?
Well, this is a more complicated problem.
Give me the short version.
The short version is that the White House and our senators haven't gotten together and come up with replacements for the judges that are presently vacant.
So President Trump, the White House, and the 2 Democratic senators in New Jersey, Booker and Menendez, have to agree.
They have to agree. Now, I have talked to the White House counsel. I've sat down with him. He was kind enough to give me a lot of time, and as did Senator Menendez and Senator Booker, all of which assure me they're working on it. But right now, we're second, maybe first now in the country, with the oldest vacancies. Some of these vacancies are 3 years old, and they haven't
been resolved. There's nobody
there? Listen, as of right now, we don't have anybody that's been nominated and confirmed for U.S. Marshal in New Jersey, federal district court judges, U.S. attorney, and there's a Third Circuit, although I saw something in the news that may be a Third Circuit appointment coming up. But that's where we are. And when you say, how does it affect the people? Look, we handle, for example, Social Security cases.
Right.
Social Security cases are appeals from people who claim to be totally disabled, potentially financially in financial straits, and that need a resolution to their case.
No judge, what happens?
The case waits and waits, and these people need help, and they need, and they have a right to have their case heard in a timely fashion. So we need more judges. And when I say we're in a judicial crisis, it's not really about the judges. The judges are going to work with whatever cases
people.
They have. It's about the people in New Jersey.
Is there anything people in New Jersey can do?
Yeah, I think they can. It is a political system in that the people in the political world have to come together and agree on an appropriate package that's agreeable to both sides, whatever that may be, to get this vacancies full. And it is a slow process. There's got to be a nomination, then it's got to be a Senate Judiciary Committee hearing, and then a full Senate vote. So even if they were to act on it in the next month or two, we're still looking at a year with this court working at, you know, 37% down, potentially almost 50%, because if you think of the court as one that really should be functioning at 20 judges, because as has been determined, because of the numbers of filings that we have over 16,000 filings last year, over 16,000. Now, if you look at
a few
that
seconds,
number,
well, we're actually going to continue the conversation on our online version, but finish your statement.
My statement simply was going to be that if you look at the number of cases and the number of judges that has been acknowledged we're required to have, we're almost at a 50% level, which affects not the amount of work the judges are doing. It's the same amount of work. It's the citizens' cases being litigated, the corporate cases being litigated, the people that need their cases heard not being heard.
With the chief judge of the New Jersey Federal District Court, Jose Linares, we'll continue the conversation online. Check out our online version. But thank you, Judge.
Thank you.
Check you out next week.
State of Affairs with Steve Adubato is a production of the Caucus Educational Corporation, celebrating over 25 years of broadcast excellence. State of Affairs with Steve Adubato is brought to you from the Agnes Varis NJTV studio at 2 Gateway. Funding has been provided by the law firm of Gibbons, PC, New Jersey Resources, Summit Medical Group, the New Jersey Education Association, Georgian Court University, New Jersey Council of County Colleges, and by the Fidelco Group.